One inmate still has not been accounted for in the five released by Governor Haley Barbour before he left office. That man is Joseph Osment. The four others have been checking in every 24 hours as this legal battle builds whether Governor Haley Barbour crossed the line by pardoning more than 200 inmates before he left office. It is a developing story we're staying on top of.
God bless him. Touch Haley Barbour's heart to do this for us.
One of those released murderers is Anthony McCray.
It's a blessing to be out. See your children, trying to fend help, taking care of the children, stuff like that. I've been saved. I've been baptized. I've been reading the Bible for 12 and a half years.
McCray was convicted of killing his wife, but Haley Barbour argues because that is a crime of passion, McCray is a less likely threat to society. He says those were the types of inmates sent to work at the governor's mansion. He pardoned some in his first term.
For the record, I have no role in deciding who gets to be a trustee at the governor's mansion, and had never heard of any of these men or any of the other trustees who served at the governor's mansion before the Department of Corrections sent them over there to work.
Barbour says the majority of the 200-plus inmates who were pardoned were given releases because of medical expense to the state. He claims Attorney General Jim Hood's attempt to stop him is politically motivated. Hood argues because the proper notice was not printed in newspapers, many of those inmates should stay put or come back.
You know, when Ronnie Musgrove, my predecessor, left office, the day he left, he pardoned someone, never published anything in any newspaper in the world. Jim Hood didn't peep.
It's the most horrendous thing I've seen an act of any governor to pull and then violate the Constitution on top of all of it. Bad enough, he turns out a bunch of murderers that juries have found guilty, and rapists, child molesters, all these type of offenses.
In the case of Karen Irby in 2010, she pleaded guilty to the drunk driving deaths of two doctors the year before.
In the trial of the Karen Irby case here in Jackson, that the family of one of the victims asked the judge for leniency.
But she has been behind bars less than 2 years. Dr. John Dedusis is the brother of Lisa Dedusis, killed in that fiery car crash in 2009 by Karen Irby. During her sentencing hearing, he did request leniency from Judge Tommy Green. But by phone, he told WAPT he wasn't expecting this. Talk about a travesty of justice for the victims, the families, for all the people of Mississippi. He has started a Facebook site in response. It's called Victims of Mississippi Pardons.